Morning, Nikki from Gracie's house. So this morning, feeling a bit tired. Got a nice cup of tea. I'm back in the workshop. It is a bit colder than I'd like. I've not put the heater on yet, but I'm loving my new lights. So the other day I had the electricians in and they've put me new lights in. So I've not got to have much light going on the ring this morning because my workshop lights are now awesome. So this morning, I have already photographed the bookcase that I painted yesterday. So that got finished. I did it the last set of top coating before I even did the school run. Multitasking mummy. So hi, Maria. Yes, so that's in photographed. And I've done a little time lapse of me staging that piece as well. So that's a bit fun. Hi, Lisa. Hi, Helen. Thanks everybody for watching. Hope you've got a cup of tea and you can join me. So I've got this, I've sorted a bit out here. I've got prep that I've had to do, morning Erin. I've prepped because I'm doing a live on the Redesign with Prima page this afternoon. So it's this afternoon for me, it's 2 o'clock. So if anyone's got the chance to pop on. I wasn't entirely sure what I was gonna do. So that's my slot. Who have we got? We've got Helen. Hi, Helen. Andrea. Oh, you're just watching one of me for a replay. So you've been watching me on catch up as well. Don't overdo it. Don't binge. So this afternoon, I will be doing on the Redesign with Prima page, I'm going to do a jewellery box. Hi, Debbie. I'm doing a jewellery box that I bought for Gracie from a charity shop. And I've painted it ready. You've got your coffee. Excellent. And so I'm going to be adding some transfers to a jewellery box, which is going to be for Gracie's birthday or Christmas present. So that's exciting. She has no idea this is coming. It's just a little one, but I think she's going to love that. Anyway, let's not talk about that anymore. We're going to talk about what I'm going to do today. Hi, Jackie. All my comments are coming through today. Don't know what happened yesterday. About halfway through, I just stopped seeing comments. So I'm hoping that's not going to happen again today. I think I've shown you this already. I think I showed you the hardware. This is battered. This piece has been used and abused. There's lots of dents in the top. I've had to rebuild a bit here. I've filled in a massive chunk was missing here. There's bits of this trim. There's a bit missing here. I'm not gonna be precious about it. This has had a life. And I'm not ever going to make it perfect, so I'm not going to try and fill in all of the little problems. But this one was huge, so I did have to fill that in. Because you could basically, there was a whole piece missing. It wasn't just a little chip. There was a whole chunk missing, and you could see into the drawer. So there's been a little bit of rebuilding. It's been sanded, because it had a really grotty, dirty finish on it. Hi, Patricia. Hi, Debbie. And Maria. Another Maria. You're from Portugal. Thank you for watching. So, in the description is all of the colours I'm going to be using, but I will do a little run through now. We're going to be doing a bit more of a messy blend. You're not going to see all of that as it happens. There's going to be layers. There's going to be lots of layers here. So I just want to get my bases on this morning with you guys and have a little chat. Who we got? What did I fill it with? Nikki, I use... I've got it to hand, let me grab it. So for normal everyday repairs, filling holes where your hardware's been and things like that, I use Dixie mud, and Dixie mud is awesome. It's really multi-purpose. I use it for raised stenciling. Jackie's, you're interested as well. Okay, so I use a two-part filler called Big Boy. What a great name. Look at the little baby boy thing that's on it. It's weird. It's like, it's probably a body filler, like a car body filler. And you can get wood versions, but this, Lisa, you've tried fine surface filler. Silk seems to eat it. Yeah, when you're building something up, I think it's really difficult when you're using any filler to get a really seamless finish from filler to, it doesn't seem to matter how smooth you can make it. This is pretty good, and it's hard. It's because it's used in body repairs, it dries rock hard. but it means you can really finesse your finish. So it works well. So it's a two-part filler. So that's got the main part, and then there's a little tube that is the hardener, which is pink. It makes it pink. So it's good stuff. But there's several different versions of this. I know, hello big boy. But you know, this is just, I think, probably the one that was on the quickest Amazon delivery, but actually it does me fine, and it you know, I've not had any problems with it. I've just seen a message pop up as well. Lisa, does mud dry hard? Yes, it does, but it doesn't, in my opinion, it doesn't dry hard enough to be like a constructive finish. So yes, it does. It's brilliant for filling hardware holes and things. When you were decorating, you used epoxy two-part filler. Yeah, I think this is probably that kind of thing. You've got to have good ventilation. It pongs a lot. But my dad used to work in body shops, in car workshops. I love the smell. It just reminds me of when I was like tiny. So, hey, I've got Hakey watching as well. That's lovely. Thank you. Let's get back to the colours. Okay, you think you need a big boy. Lisa, naughty. So we've got Midnight Sky. I'm going to do a graduated, messy sort of blend on this one. Bit grungy. This is going to be at the bottom, and I'm going to graduate up. I have one of my favourites, Antebellum Blue. Oh, it's delicious, isn't it? It's just lovely. I have Peacock. I have Pure Ocean. I have The Gulf. I have Farmhouse Green. And wild card, Terracotta. Cheeky, hey? This is probably, you might not see me use this one today. I think this is going to be once we've kind of got to a bit more finishing point, and this is, I'm probably going to use a scraper to put this on. Interesting. But what I'll do is I'll try and come on and do the stages with you that you might. Yeah, I know you love messy and grungy. Okay. So I'm just gonna start. I think. Oh, shall I start at the top or shall I start at the bottom? What do you think? What do you want to? Where do you want me to start? This is going to be highlights as well. So really, I'm going to be starting with The Gulf or Midnight Sky. Which one do you think? Should we have some votes? I'm going to wait for a couple of minutes to see votes come in on whether you want me to start on the top or the bottom. And what are you doing today? Is it cold? We had another hard frost this morning. I've actually started wearing my woolly hat on the school run. But it is November. Okay, we've got two. You want me to start at the bottom. Okay, you guys got in there first. I'm gonna go with the bottom then. Okay. I've got a little bit left in this pot. I've got a backup already. Oh, Charlie, you missed out. Too many people are saying the bottom, I'm afraid. Someone else has just said the top. I think we've still got more. I'm going to put a little bit. The other great thing with Dixie Belle, so I've had this for quite a while. So you can see it's proper crusty on the top. It's gone pretty thick. It's not solid, but you can see it's hardly moving. And I don't keep my paint in the workshop. This is kept in the kitchen. But the great thing is, you can just stick a bit of water in and give it a shake up. And often that's just enough to loosen it up. Crikey, we've got a Sharon Stone watching. Hi, Sharon. It's cold in France. Oh, but sunny, yeah. Yesterday we had some nice sun, today not so much. Oh, hey, I know, too many people have said start at the bottom now. Sunny in Holland, woo! 20 degrees? I'm quite jealous now. Okay, let's crack on. So I have my usual array of brushes. I have my Dixie Belle Oval Medium, my Mini. What I really want to get my hands on when they come back into stock is the, I think it's the Flat Medium. I want to get my hands on a few of those. I think I'm gonna really like that brush. But these are the two, and then I have my little cheapies. They're not chip brushes, but they're kind of on that level, but they're fine filament, so they do a good job. Okay. It took me a while to decide what colours to work on with this. So I do like, who else goes on Pinterest for, Pinterest is all about inspiration, but I too go on Pinterest and get ideas. I find it really useful, especially if I'm just kind of, I've got an idea, but it's not quite getting out. I'm not quite pulling it out enough of my head. And I do love Midnight Sky, it's such a nice colour. So because this is going to be a messy blend, I'm not worried too much about a really, really smooth finish. Like I said, this piece has been battered. It's got bits missing and broken that I'm not going to build up. I'm just not going to bother. And when I got this, a few people said, oh, it should have legs. They didn't have legs. Some people put legs on. I am not going to. I think you have to get it so absolutely right for the proportions to look right, and this is how it was made. I'm leaving it like that. This is lovely. The Dixie Belle Mini is really, really nice for putting, for just getting paint on. And it's just so comfortable in the hand as well. And for changing, you know, changing angles and directions, it's great. So I don't want too much dark, but I do love a dark base. Because if you've ever done any dip dyeing, the dip end of the colour is always darker at the bottom. So my mind doesn't work so well when people do dark down. You're admiring how clean I paint. Nothing on the floor. Oh, there is. There's a little bit on the floor. I'm really trying to be careful. I can wipe it up. I'm really trying to be careful. Because this is my staging floor. It just looks nicer for you guys. I do try. Hi, Lane. So I'm going in with the Antebellum blue. I was toying with the idea of Stormy Seas, but I wanted it a little bit more punchy and not quite so grey. Stormy Seas is a bit more muted. And I used it on that little coal scuttle bedside, so I thought I'd go for a bit brighter on this one. How clean my floor is. Tried a few times to paint with the drawers in. Your paint always seals them shut. Ah, right, okay. Hi, Charlotte. Are you Charlotte that's up the road in Milton Keynes? I tend to paint them shut, especially if I'm doing something that needs, like if you're doing the same colour, it doesn't matter if you paint them out. But if you're doing a look that has to be cohesive with the drawers in and match, I'll do that. But then once I've finished, I just pull them out to say there, and then they can't seal shut. But you've not got drawers everywhere. So that works for me. But yeah, the alternative is to take them all out. But if you just pull them out to there, that should do it for you. And it depends what clearance you've got and how squadgy you've been with your paint and how much paint you've used, I suppose. I've showed you which brushes I'm using, but just as I go along, so there's no particular order, there's no particular reason. I'm going for my oval medium now. Oh, this is lovely. I do love this colour. Hi, Helen. Hi, Cheryl. So Gracie's daddy's going back into the school again to finish the filming that he started before half term. So she's got a couple of lines to do today. But I don't need to go. Yes. Lunchtime. Okay, have some lunch. See you soon. Oh, those two colours look really nice together. I love Stormy Seas too, Elaine, but I've just used it a little bit and I just thought I'm going to go a bit more punchy. That's it's a beautiful colour, but it was a bit more muted than I wanted to go for on this. I'm trying to work out how many colours I've got. 1, 2, 3. I'm going to go a bit more of this. So I haven't got a massive plan on where things are going to be, but I do. I just wanted that little bit of dark for grounding at the bottom. And then I've got my four main colours of the sort of turquoise range, which I want to be relatively evenly spaced. Hi, Julie. Oh, you're in the Isle of Man. What's your weather like? See, there's a big chunk here that's missing of the trim of the drawer, and I was planning on filling that, and I forgot. So I should probably just leave it. Deborah, you've got Klingon brushes, but you've asked for Dixie Belle for Christmas. I've never used a Klingon brush, actually, but I've heard really, really good things. Mini, oval, flat, or all? Oh, yeah. Oh, go high. Go in high. Hi, Sue. Yeah, Jackie, it's gone over the filler, great. Because it's white, that's the only thing with the two-part fillers, because they're not particularly wood fillers, you don't get a brown. So your mix will be a white, slightly pinky white. But, you know, this is one coat. It's not bad at all. And I haven't used any, there's no boss or anything on this. Obviously, I wasn't going to do white, but I didn't use a clear or anything. It is mahogany, but it's, I'm just fingers crossed, I'm not going to have a problem. You're going to let, yeah, you can, yeah, definitely let the other half know. And what's everyone else got on their Santa's list? It's getting close, isn't it? It's my birthday on, I think it's Monday. And it's, do you know what, isn't it tricky as you get older to have like, to have a list? I find it really difficult. Like when my husband says, what do you want for your birthday? What do you want for Christmas? I'm like, I have no idea. Does everyone else find that? Is it an age thing? Or am I just boring? Or do we just kind of get ourselves up the stuff we want as we go nowadays? Hi, Julie. Hi, Sue. Ringwood. My mum's from Ringwood. I know Ringwood well. Erin, festals on the Christmas list, of course. I couldn't wait. It was on the Christmas list. Lockdown, I know, lockdown birthday. It was, yes, the festival was on the Christmas list, but I was getting so busy through the first lockdown that I just felt like it was going to be a really good investment. So, hi Nicoletta. Oh, Charlotte, so you've got a sander and you want the extractor. Honestly, game changer. I did fork out for the whole kit together. But best investment ever. It's just, because you're probably like, I think you were like me. I remember seeing you posting saying you were sanding in your driveway. It's basically me. I was sanding out of the front of the workshop. So I've got one of my cheaper brushes now. And I'm going in now with Peacock. So the next colour up. but yeah, you know, having to work around whether it's raining and... let's face it, okay, if it's not raining, that's fine. But if you've got a really hard frost that's day long and there's no sun, your hands get cold sanding. It is freezing. I could not sand for very long outside. So yeah, it's great. Rachel, you want some indoor plants? Ah, real ones? Are you good with plants? I try my best. There's a few that I'm okay with. I'm kind of half and half with fakes and real ones at the moment. I've got some that I'm doing okay. Cheese plants, really easy to look after. You always think of the thing, good things after your birthday, Jackie, that yes, yeah, all of a sudden there's something you really need. Hang on, I know that I missed a comment and I'm doing my best. Sue says she loves the blues. You've got a little mahogany piece which is going to be blues. Ah, you've got the silk stencils. I've got a couple, but I haven't used any yet. So it sounds like you've got a plan. We're quicker. Which festool have I got? Sharon, I have got the RTS 400 with the MIDI extractor. So it's just a little square shaped, sort of rectangle shaped one, but it is really good. Awesome. I think as a first one, it kind of covers as much as I need it to cover. Now these, they have got these little brass things in, and at the moment I'm painting over them, but I can just scrape that off if I really choose to. I'm not 100% sure what the plan is there yet. You just sand in your lounge and Hoover. Yeah, but in your lounge, wow. Yeah, I know, that's what I used to do in my kitchen with Hoovering, obviously, without an extractor. And I tried to link up to a shop vacuum, but none of the attachments fit. And you end up masking tape and mess and the Festool makes a huge, but you know what? I'm already window shopping for the next sander part. So all of the sanders are, can obviously mix and match to the extractor. I'm already looking for the next one because they do one that's smaller with a delta tip. Oh, terrible. I'm already looking. This Peacock is so punchy, isn't it? How cool is that? And I'm just running the brush over a little bit so it's not just a completely solid line. So I've got a little kind of basic blend going on there so that I'm not fighting against a solid line on my next lot of coat, my next coat. Doesn't have to be. I've not used any water on this piece at all yet. I think partly because it's cold. If it's warmer, you need a bit more water going on because it dries quicker. But this piece has been stored in the workshop, so the piece is cold as well, so it just doesn't dry very quickly. Okay, let's go in with the Pure Ocean. So, no, this isn't silk. This is all main range on this one. Helen, no worries. Deborah, new sander attachment, yeah. Rachel, you've put the real ones, air purifying ones, plants, of course. Yes, I know, and that's why I really, really try my best with real ones. Because I have a thing, I love using greenery to stage with. I think it makes your pictures pop really well. But there's some plants I just can't keep alive. But it does actually bother me that I have like a bit of an internal fight and struggle thinking, oh, all these fake plants that are plastic versus real ones. The struggle is real. So these lighter colours, they're going to struggle a bit more to give you as fuller coverage as what I've got going on down here. But this is first rough coat. I do not mind. I'm going to be doing at least one more coat anyway. Okay, what did Jackie say? Yeah, Jackie, you struggled. So Jackie has just done her first piece. She's bravely shown it recently in the last few days. After watching, I would imagine, hours of lives from content creators and brand ambassadors. I much prefer, even on this first one, to just do a really rough blend. It just makes life easier. I did it very, very faintly down here. It just makes life easier going forward. This one. And you see, you can just do it here, look. It just makes your life so much easier when you come to do the follow-up blending. Cece's, do you know what I've noticed? That Cece and Brandy both just put their, and I think, does Christina do it as well? They like butt up against. I just really struggle with doing that with my subsequent blending coats. So they do it. Obviously it's doable for me personally, I just find having a rough blend on my first coat helps a lot. I'm going to go up a bit higher with this. This is the Pure Ocean, isn't it, I'm working with? Yeah, so this is Pure Ocean. Already, I am loving it. I was worried that it wasn't going to be... When I was picking my colours out, I was thinking, oh, maybe I need a bit more green in there. And then I put green in with it, and it just wasn't quite... I'm digging it so far. Yeah, Jackie. So have you started another piece yet, Jackie? Or is it, you know, is that taken out of you? You're having a little chill. Okay. I'm just gonna get, what's that colour there? I've got a little dribble coming where I squodged too much paint in the old hardware hole. So this has two sets of hardware. Originally, it would have had big mahogany knobs. They were missing. This has got some really, really pretty vintage steel hardware that I'm going to clean up. Not sure what colour I'm going to do it yet. But I'm quite pleased with how it's looking so far. So, look, it's just caught in the big holes. But I can't be bothered. To be honest, I just can't be bothered to fill those big holes in. They're covered up by the new hardware, not the new hardware, but the replacement hardware. So there we go. Erin, you're a sucker for the blues. It's really pretty, isn't it? I love it. Right, last blue, the Gulf. Jackie, you're still just staring at your one piece. Are you selling it or are you keeping it? I can't remember whether you've told me or not. So last of the bluey colours is the Gulf. This is the colour I've painted the jewellery box that I'm going to work on later. So this has got a slight green tint to it. And I think, I don't know how the colours are coming up on your end, but it looks slightly bluer on my camera to what it does here. So I don't know if that's what you're seeing or whether I'm seeing something slightly different, but this has definitely got a little bit of green in it. What we got there? Finish a good book and you can't start another. So, you're having a breather. So, this is, what colour did I say this was, guys? The Gulf. We're doing the Gulf now. Yeah, so it's always pretty. Pretty, pretty, pretty. I need to get a... Let's get that in there. Scoop that paint out of there. There we go. You want to build up a few pieces and then open an Etsy store. Good for you. Etsy is my biggest platform to sell on. By a long shot. Commissions is different. Commissions, I get a lot of local commission business. But actual selling and to be national, Etsy's huge for me. Matilda, do you like this extra colour on the top? Yeah, Karen, you've missed it again. All the colours are listed in the description at the top, but yeah, we'll catch you later. Whoa. I've got so many pots of paint open, I've got to be careful I don't dip my brush in the wrong ones. It's sort of more beachy than I was intending in my head. In my head. Who else likes Donkey from Shrek? We think our dog looks like Donkey. Just seeing a bit there. Do you know the amount of times that I come off alive with you guys and I go around the other side of the piece? I've missed loads of bits where I'm not at the right angle. The Gulf is lush. It's really, really pretty. I'm feeling like there might be some gold leaf involved in this. I'm definitely getting metallics out as well. You have to figure out deliveries and fee structure. Yes. Not, well, yeah. I mean, yeah, you've got to figure out your your pricing structure. But do you know what? That'll come. And deliveries, once you get a couple under your belt and you get a courier that you can trust, or a couple of couriers. I've got three couriers now that I go to routinely to do my deliveries, and they each cover different areas of the country. So I'm kind of they're not directly competing for business with me either. Having said that, just lately, most of my stuff's been going north. I've previously had lots go to London, but at the moment, it's all been going north. Scotland, even as far as Scotland, but Liverpool and all sorts, yeah. Yeah, I'm definitely feeling some gold leaf. If I do gold, how do they offer free delivery? Jackie, if anyone's offering free delivery, they're building it into their price. Now, there may be that they've got some couriers that are giving them like a flat rate. My couriers don't work that way. And at the moment, where jobs are kind of, just with everybody and the going into lockdown thing, it's been tricky. So the prices have been a bit more, and you do have to beware. So I have used Shipley, but you have to beware with Shipley that there's a lot of people coming over and they're just crazy, crazy low prices, but then your stuff's getting damaged. So you do have to be really, really careful. Message me when you're ready. I can try and help you out. Charlie, if I do gold leaf, can I do a live? You want to try it. You're nervous. Oh, have fun. Honestly, gold leaf is awesome fun. It's so much fun. Let me just see what the rest of you said. Oh, you don't have a piece for it either. You just want to try it. It's really, really good fun. You need to make sure you've kind of got everything else covered up. It gets everywhere. It gets up your nose. It's in your hair. When I go to school and do the school run after I've done, everyone knows I've done gold leafing that day, because it's like it just sticks to you everywhere. But yes, I can. Why not? No worries. Let's do it. So I don't think you're gonna see me use terracotta today. I haven't got my hairdryer up here either, so I can't. Let's just make sure that blend sort of matches across there. I'm just gonna run my brush over. The peacocks, so damp looking. Some dribbles. Do you see how long ago did I do the peacock and it's still really wet, really wet? So that just goes to show you how cold my workshop is. But yeah, I'm thinking it's to sort of a bit, I might use some sea spray and some texture in there as well. Okay, there's a lot of love for gold leaf, so we'll work on that. I'll pick out my gold leaf and I'll plan a live once everything else is done, because really gold leaf is the last thing before top coat, so it will be towards the end of it. What we got there? Sue, I know gold leafing's awesome. Esther, you've gold leafed small pieces but not a large piece. Yeah, it will just be, it'll be little bits here and there, but it's super effective, so that'd be great. You recommended, Andrina recommends a shower cap when you're gold leafing. How big is that shower cap? It does get everywhere. It's in your eyebrows, in like all in my little hairs around the front. It's very pretty. Gold and maybe copper. I mean, yeah, Leslie, it could actually be copper leafing on this with the colours, rather than gold. I'm gonna crack open the farmhouse green, but I'm not feeling that I'm not ready for the terracotta yet. But let's get a little bit of this. So you guys a couple of days ago were watching me use this one. Really, really pretty light green. Really pretty. And, but I'm not, this is still, I'm just going to be using it for little bits here and there on this one. So I've got one. I've got these little artist brushes as well. These are well used. I'm not putting a shower cap on live, Jackie. I'm not. Maybe a towel turban. Perhaps. Can you imagine doing a live wearing a shower cap? Funny. So my thinking is a bit sort of crusty and. Let's just see. You know, to just highlight these edges. What do you think? And I'm not going to be too fussy on how it's going on. A little bit around the edges as well. But I am kind of getting into, this is like the next layer really I should be doing this on. Esther, did it? What did you do? Did you wear a shower cap? Do it. Oh, okay. Oh, really? I could always say I haven't got one. I know, Jackie, this farmhouse green is awesome, isn't it? And it's just so subtle. It does go with this. Because it went with the duck egg and the stormy seas the day before yesterday. But actually, it's going really nicely here as well. So that's the kind of the thing we're going for. And I may even bring that down onto these, the corners of these ones as well, and grunge it around the keyhole and things. So I quite like that. Oh, do you know what? I'm going to open the terracotta. I'm doing it. I'm getting the terracotta out. Esther, you're going to send me a shower. Oh, I think I have got one. Can't get this lid off. I can't get the plastic off the lid. My tea's gone cold. It's definitely got cold. So we're liking the farmhouse green. I'm loving that, actually. Oh, sorry, noise. There we go. This one hasn't even been opened and it's stuck on. Okay, so this is one of the colours that only comes in the 16-ounce size. And ultimately, I think this is going to last me a long time because I think this is literally going to be highlighting. I can't ever imagine doing a whole piece in terracotta. But it is a nice, muted, almost like rusty sort of colour. It is nice. So it's much, much more subdued than Florida orange. Oh, but look, hang on, let me wipe my fingers. Look how lush it looks up against antebellum blue. Ooh. Lisa, you left for a minute and I finished the front. Well, first coat finish, just first coat. And I wasn't gonna do any of the farmhouse green or the terracotta, but because we're having a little chat, having a bit of fun, I've decided I've cracked open both. So, yeah, the antebellum and terracotta look amazing. And actually, just those two pieces together. Oh, can you imagine a mid-century piece in those two? I think that would look amazing. So I am just going to go in with a little bit here. And I'm going to kind of do the same thing down here. And it kind of gives that kind of aged... Like I said, I might get the sea spray out and mix some sea spray with this, but it gives that sort of aged, I can imagine this belonged to a mermaid now. Lisa, you need terracotta now. I know. Jackie thinks it would pair with neutrals like sandbar and burlap. Yeah, I feel like it would still be a highlight colour with those, whereas if it looks so pretty up against the antebellum, I actually could see it working as quite a focused, you know, as quite a bold colour with antebellum rather than just a highlight. Okay. And I might come back with some sea spray and additive and mix it up and make it a bit
sort of crustier and get more texture on these bits. It's picking up so much. It's so wet still. And I can come like along here as well and just pick out some details here. And what I will do on the subsequent coats, I'll be using the water a lot more to get some drips going on. Black and terracotta would look great. Caviar and terracotta. So there's, it's a black lid. I haven't got a black. But yeah, that would look very bold and fabulous. So how many people are going to buy terracotta now? I've put too much on there. There's my scraper. So I said about the scraper, you see, you can just, I'm taking off paint from underneath because it's still a bit wet there. Jodie from Decorous Designs uses, Decorous Vintage Design, sorry, she uses a scraper quite often. Yeah, it's all a bit wet. I'm gonna have to stop. I can't stop. But it's great, it's a great way to create texture, the scraper as well. So can you see where I'm going with it? Yeah. Fabulous. You just shouted that out loud. Love it. Yeah, it's all too wet, but you get where I'm going with it. So I'm gonna leave it there. I'll do the sides, but that'll be more of the same. Obviously, this is all gonna be a bit grungy, but a bit mermaidy. I'm liking where it's going. I hope you've enjoyed this one this morning. Stop it. Jackie, have I missed something? Is it me adding extra colours? Oh, stop it. No, don't. Who used to say that? Can't remember. You like how it looks more opaque over the light colours? Yes, it does. I mean, it's because this peacock is really, really wet still. So you could make it more opaque, and it will be, but yeah. Okay guys, Suzanne, I think you've just joined us, but I'm just coming to the end, so if you want to catch us up and watch replay. So thank you for taking the time, as always, to watch me. Go over and give my page some love if you haven't already. If you're watching on replay, drop me a hashtag replay. If you've got any questions about anything else, always drop me comments. I really, really do try and keep going back in and answering any questions that I might have missed or anything that you've added that you might think of later down the line. Stop making you buy all the colours I use. Yeah. Lisa, your list is getting longer. Okay. Good. If you're in America, don't forget to use my link. And if you've got time this afternoon, 2 p.m. My time. It might have come up in your timeline if you're on different time zones. It's supposed to convert, but it's 2 p.m. for me. To see me adding a transfer to some jewellery boxes. One jewellery box. See you later. Bye.